what we strive to do in East Africa is to serve all communities, all consumers who are able to buy our drinks. And so we operate right at the top end of the marketplace with people that can afford to buy Tusker or even some of our spirits brands such as Johnny Walker. But we also concentrate on eradicating illicit by providing Senator at a very value-driven price. And so covering all price points and all consumers is our magic recipe.
And that's why in Kenya you've got around 80% of the market.
Yeah, we've got a huge market share in Kenya, which we're very proud of, and we're also very humble about, so we know that we'll only continue to keep that market share if we continue to give consumers what they want, and often, particularly with the millennials these days becoming around 40% of the total market. New products with innovation, we've just launched Tusker in a cider format, which appeals to millennials and appeals to a sweeter palate. So we're constantly trying to keep on top of our game and keep creating new ideas.
You do have market dominance within the Kenyan market specifically, very strong footprint within the East African region. How do you plan to ensure that people continue to order your brands?
We need to continue to keep the brand modern and relevant to all consumers. And so over the past few years, we've got the centerpiece of Tusker, which is Tusker Lager. We've also launched into a Tusker Malt, which is a more discerning liquid. We've also launched Tusker Light, which the young people really love. And in the last few months, we've launched Tusker Cider, which is appealing to both women and a sweeter palate, and also the guys too. So continuing to reinvent Tusker and keep it relevant to Kenyan and East African households is really, really important.
Where do you make your most money though? From the low end of the spectrum in terms of the Senator beers, or is it Tusker, is it your spirits? Where do you see the most profits?
I mean, what we want in EABL is to make sustainable profits, and there's different margins on all of the different products. We certainly couldn't provide Senator at 25 shillings per mug and make lots and lots of money out of it, but it goes beyond the money, and so Senator isn't just about the money. Of course, we're a commercial business. We're a very large PLC here in Kenya, and so we have a responsibility to our shareholders to continue to grow our profits, and we do that through the whole breadth of the range.
Okay, so SAB Miller had a tough time entering this market. I mean, they had no chance against you guys back in the early 2000s. How do you respond to that being the dominant player in the Kenyan market?
I think the reason we're so big is because we've got brands like Tusker, brands like Johnny Walker Whiskey, brands like Senator, that consumers want to buy. And our obsession is to provide consumers with drinks they want at the prices they can afford.
Is it also because you've got very strong resources from Diageo as well, that you're able to pump the right resources into making sure that you hold on to your market share?
I mean, our business is very, very well invested. We'll spend $50 million this year alone on increased capacity because our business is growing and more consumers are buying more and more of our products. But actually, almost 100% of that investment is going into providing around 300 million mugs of Senator, which is at the lower end of our portfolio. So, you know, we are agnostic about what consumers want and what they can afford, as long as we can provide a solution for it.
Is that what you think, that that's going to be the secret recipe?
Absolutely. Give consumers what they want at the prices they can afford.
So, I mean, what does it take to win over the Kenyan consumer specifically, do you think?
I think the Kenyan consumer is really dynamic. I mean, my previous job was I ran the UK business for Diageo. And the Kenyan consumer is mobile savvy, digitally savvy, highly aspirational, very contemporary, very, very ambitious. And therefore, we've got to provide new products and innovative ideas for them to enjoy. So deeply understanding not just the Kenyan consumer, but the dynamic that's going on with the Kenyan consumer and how they're contemporizing, I think is really key.
Have you seen consumers buying up or buying down over the year? I mean, what is the big trend that you're seeing?
There's actually a really exciting trend going on in Kenya, which I think typifies my point about millennials and more demanding Kenyan consumers. So we've seen enormous growth in our spirits business. And the reason for that is consumers who would historically have only had a lager, only had a Tusker, are now exploring. So they want to try a gin and tonic, or they want to try a Johnny Walker whiskey. And so their repertoire, as the marketeers would call it, is really broadening. And so our spirits business is in significant double-digit growth at the moment. And that's a trend we expect to see continue for the next few years.